Okay, if you were watching QC at 3 yesterday, we told you about this drink that's selling for $23 just for one at the U.S. Open. Mm-hmm. It's called the Honey Deuce. It's the signature drink of the tournament. Last year, more than 460,000 drinks were sold, totaling more than $10 million. And officials are expecting to sell even more this year. But here's the thing. It has three ingredients. $23 for three ingredients. Now, four if you do the honeydew melon on top to look like tennis balls. Our buddy Russ Johnson from the Public House is here this morning. Russ, should I be paying $23 for that cocktail?
You know, if you're at the U.S. Open, I would say absolutely. But neither you nor I are there right now.
No, we are not. Know? We're probably watching on TV from our living rooms.
Absolutely. I'm watching it actually at Public House.
I'm watching it in my office. Don't tell anyone.
You can take this with you. So the Wilmington has its Pimm's Cup.
Okay.
It's the official drink.
Yep.
Kentucky Derby, its official drink is going to be the mint julep.
Yep.
And this is the official drink of the U.S. Open called the Honey Deuce.
Okay, so it does have some cute elements to it.
Sure.
Does this drink exist in any other life under any other name?
No, this was sort of invented by one of the reps from Grey Goose in the early 2000s.
Mm-hmm.
And it just gained popularity at the U.S. Open.
All right, so we talked about three ingredients. The three ingredients are right here.
Absolutely. Those are the only three ingredients you need. Obviously, Grey Goose is one of the sponsors, so that's how it got started.
Mm-hmm.
But you can use whatever kind of vodka you'd like. I would definitely recommend a premium raspberry liqueur. One of my favorites is Chambord, but
mm-hmm.
you can use whatever you'd like. And then the lemonade, you can make it yourself. I think you can definitely find some good deals on some lemonade in the grocery store as well. And
when
then the honeydew. You just make couple of scoops with the melon baller, and there you go.
I'm going to ask you about that in just a second because
sure.
I can never get those scoops right. But when you have only three ingredients, you mentioned having like a premium raspberry liqueur. Excuse me. Is it nice to have better ingredients when you're doing a cocktail like this because there are only three?
Yes, I would say 100%. And like you said, it's only three ingredients, and it's
mm-hmm.
a very simple cocktail to make at home, and you can make it in a batch for a lot of friends. See, I just want to go play right now.
My goodness, the racket's just trying to fly out of the bag.
I'm jonesing.
Tell me a little bit about making these melon balls, because they look really cute on top of the drink.
They do, and they obviously make some smaller ones.
Yeah.
I just kind of chose this one. Three, obviously those are mass produced there.
Mm-hmm.
These are fresh
yes.
this morning. So
great.
You just kind of just want to kind of go in sort of on the top,
yep.
spin it around, and the reason I like these is because you can just do that.
Oh, that's brilliant.
You're good to go.
They look so cute. All right, so in this glass already is?
Yes, so in this we have 1 1/4 ounce vodka,
mm-hmm.
full of ice and lemonade,
mm-hmm.
and then all you have to do is finish it off with about 1/2 ounce of Chambord or raspberry liqueur.
I love Chambord. Oh, look how pretty that is.
And then if you want to get festive, I've got you a nice little umbrella over there. I know
yes, please.
We like to get festive
we
on the show.
We do.
And then
did you just skewer the how cute.
Got you. And the reason that they skewer three
uh-huh.
is obviously to mimic the can of tennis balls.
That is so smart. I only have 30 seconds left. Remind people about the Public House, where
yes.
it is as we put the information up on
Public
the
House. We're at 300 South Bavard Street. We're right down the street from the NASCAR Hall of Fame, as well as the Convention Center. We're open 7 days a week, 4 o'clock until 2 a.m. with a full food menu until 1:15, 1:30. Also, Sundays, we're doing brunch. So come see me, 11 o'clock in the morning, and I'll be there.
He'll be there. The food there is really good.
I love it.
It's really good.
I love it.
All right, can we taste?
Yes, of course.
Cheers. Cheers, my friend.
Cheers.
Oh, that Chambord makes it. Mwah! That is delicious.
So good. It's like a raspberry lemonade.
Ooh, that is good. That is good. Thank you, Russ. Good to see you.
That's a good combo.